Hello there, my name is Verax and welcome to my second Let's Play of Blood Bowl, this one in Chaos Edition. Last one we played as the Nurgle team, the Roughskins. This time, if you saw the last video, you will already know, we are playing as the Verirats, the Skaven. They are named after an Expendables style sort of theme, so we have a bunch of movie stars with us, basically. There we are. So we haven't played any games whatsoever yet. If you're new to Blood Bowl, and some of you will be, I'm going to try and sort of summarise what I'm doing. But in order to make it not too tedious for people who do know what's happening, and because the turns are limited in time, they're all timed, it's I might be quite brief and just sort of gloss over things. But yes, we are the Skaven. Skaven are ratmen, and they're very quick and are very good in offense, I believe. They're very good at scoring touchdowns. Not so good at getting the ball back again. It works a lot like American football. They kick it to you, you pick it up, and then run down and try and get the ball to the end of their end zone, and then it repeats itself, kind of thing, until the end of 16 turns, unless it has to go to sudden death or whatever. Here's our team roster. We have Arnie as the Rat Ogre. Players have certain statistics. That's movement, that's how many squares they can move. These are quite high because Skaven are a very fast team, especially these guys, as you can see. Strength is how good they are at bashing people, and I'll just do that by numbers. So it's really how good they are at bashing people, pretty much. Agility is how good they are at handling the ball, how good they are at passing, how good they are at dodging, and sort of agility-based stuff like that. Armor value is how good they are at resisting injuries when they get knocked down. Skaven don't have fantastic armor values. This is basically a roll they have to hit on two d6, two-sided dice in order to save. So you roll two dice, you get seven or more, you're okay. If you get less than that, then you take an injury, and that can be quite bad. So we're going to be seeing a lot of injuries and a lot of deaths, I imagine. Players can level up with star player points when they get from scoring touchdowns, doing passes and other neat stuff. And that's their value when if they're injured or whatever. They also have skills down here and any skills gained, which they won't have. Because no one has gained any skills yet. No one's leveled up. So, you've got the Rat Ogre, who's a big, mean bastard. Two Storm Vermin, who are a little bit more hardy than the rest of the rats. And they have block, which could be a nice sort of melee type skill. Michelle Rodriguez. Oh, I should rename them. Annie. Tommy Lee Jones and Kurt Russell are our two Stormvermin. Michelle Rodriguez is our thrower. She can pass the ball, obviously. We'll re-roll passes and re-roll to pick up the ball. Danny Trejo and Nicolas Cage are our gutter runners. Very quick, pretty agile. We're very agile, really. Agility 4. And dodge, so they can re-roll dodge rolls. Excellent. Then Sigourney Weaver, Liam Neeson, Samuel L. Jackson, Mickey Rourke, and Sean Bean as the linemen. Our run-of-the-mill rat people, whose job it is to basically just get in the way, get hit a lot, and plug in the gaps. We also have three rerolls, which I think will come in quite nicely, which I can use during each half. There are 8 matches a half, so I have three rerolls in each half. All right, let's actually see who we're against, shall we? Let's click this and find out our opponents. Goblins! We're against Goblins. Goblins are one of the, on paper, worst teams in the league, in the entire thing. But they can be extremely dangerous. They do have secret weapons, which will get sent off at certain points of the match. And that's what I'm going to end up doing, because or wanting to do, because Bombardiers, he can throw bombs at us. That is not something we like. Also, Necromantic, which I have experience of playing. And indeed, Nurgle, which I also have experience of playing. So that's our little cup type thing. That's our little league. So we're playing Goblins, Necromantic, and Nurgle over the next 3 weeks. Goblins this week. Let's prepare the match. And, right, team values based on your player's skills and levels. The AI gives its teams a bonus straight away to make the game more difficult. It's a bit lazy on the game designer's part. Hopefully they'll do better in the second game. Blood Bowl 2 is coming out at some point, as I am aware. So basically we're going to get money to make our team equal to that. And we're going to get 300,000. Very nice. So what can we get? I'm playing it on classic mode, so we don't have access to potions and some of these other things, but I don't mind that too much. Blitz mode is a little bit meh at times for the stuff that it adds. So we can get bribes, so we can foul players. We can also buy a wizard if we want. It's not really worth it though. 150 grand. It's not worth it, I don't think. I think we'd be better off. We could also buy some star players and mercenaries, but prefer to develop my own team rather than getting mercenaries. What I'll do is I will get an extra team training, which is an extra reroll. So that gives us 4. We'll get some Bloodwiser babes. And an apothecary. Yes, an apothecary we need, because I did not buy one on team creation, and that just lets us re-roll an injury roll, so if someone dies we can re-roll it and hopefully it will be better for us. So 2 Bloodwiser babes, so our characters wake up from being knocked out, and gives them a little more incentive. An apothecary and another re-roll. Let's do this. I'm excited. Are you excited? I'm excited. Let's do this. Let's do this! Oh yeah, the Vererats, their debut! This up here is star rating. It's, what is it? Fan factor, that's it, fan factor. They have 2 fan factor, we have none because we're completely new. You can buy some at the start, but I didn't bother. It affects certain things that can happen during kickoffs. Every kickoff, there's a random event rolled, which could be nothing. It could be anything from a light gust of wind to a pitch invasion. In fact, fan factor can affect certain things within that, but we'll gain fan factor as we win matches. And here we are. Let me let the cinematic play, because I will normally skip them. But as it is, our debut, we shall just let this go. We're on a ship. Oh, you'll have to notice the goblin cheerleaders on their squig riders. This is, of course, based in the Warhammer universe. We shall be tails, because we have tails. Good. Let's choose to receive the kickoff, because if I get an early kickoff, no, sorry, if I get an early, see the clock counting down, if I get an early touchdown, which I'm hoping to, I can get their special players sent off, because they're illegal. As you can see, they have a freaking bomb, and other things. Anyway, I have no idea, I'm just going to do this, I remember how to do that, nice, how to set these guys up, whether I should put the Rat Ogre in the front. He's got wild animal, which means... Alright, if he's blocking or blitzing, he can do more stuff. If, you know, I've got to roll dice. And on a roll of a 2 plus, if he's blocking or blitzing, he can do something, otherwise it's a 4 plus. I think I'll put him in the front. Might be a bad idea. Actually, it will, because of the yeah. I'm not going to put you in the front, because there's a bloody fanatic there with a big ball and chain. So we'll put you in the back, Mr. Arnie. So in the front, we'll have Samuel L. Jackson, Sigourney Weaver, and Liam Neeson. Where's Sean Bean? We need him in the front, really, because he always dies. So I have Liam Neeson back here. And Mickey Rourke can be there. Storm Vermin will put sort of further up here to protect our gutter runners, who will try and run around the sides and wherever. The thrower will be at the back in order to pick up the ball. And I think that'll do. That'll do. Right then, I'll accept that. Now he'll kick the ball to me. Oh, he also has a chainsaw as well. There's a chainsaw. Alright, this is good for us. The ball is kept very high, allowing the player and the receiving team to be moved on, into the perfect position to catch it. So, I can select you to go under that and see if she picks up the ball. Michelle Rodriguez does catch the ball. Excellent. Alright, so now it's my turn. I got 4 minutes. So what I want to do, basically, is break down the side and get the ball to a gutter runner and score. This won't always be my tactic, but as we are against goblins, Pogo are there. He is not illegal. He's just in a Pogo. Yeah, he can jump over you and stuff. Very nice. Gonna break down this side, I think. So, he also has trolls. Pretty nasty. I think I might take out... Alright, so... I wanna go down this side because the Pogo is not there. So what we can do is move her down there, and then throw to this gutter runner who can run up there. But I've got to get rid of that goblin first. And once I've moved a player, I can't move them again. So I can't move and then move you up and then throw with her. Doesn't work like that. Got to do it all at once. And if I fail a roll, my turn is over. So I move you up there to cover him. I have to dodge away in order to move. Equally, this lineman can cover this pogo. Let's put you sort of here. There. Keep their players away from these trolls. They will go stupid, probably, because if they're not coerced by a goblin, they will probably go stupid. We'll put the storm vermin in here. Now, I can only move an attack once per turn. And that's called a blitz. That's what that is. I can only move an attack once per turn. I can just attack normally once per turn, like as many times as I want, sorry. But moving and attacking, blitzing, once per turn. So I'm going to try and get this goblin out the way. Here we go. Our first one, and we get that, which is Defender Stumbles. Which means that he's got dodge, so it doesn't work. Now the dodging, it's reasonably complex, I gotta admit. The blocking and stuff. What all the different dice rolls mean and such. So I can get you down here. And I don't have to pass this turn, of course. I might see if I can... Right, we'll get this... we'll get Danny Trejo to come down here as well. Now, these dice means I can go for it. So I can actually move that many. I can move 11 if I want to. But that means that I have to roll dice for each of these. On a roll of a 1, it'll fall over. And that's my turn over. Unless I want to re-roll it, but it's a bit early for that. You notice I can't blitz with the Rat Ogre, with Arnie. Because I've already blitzed. I was to get him out of the way, but I decided I wouldn't bother anyway, so it was probably a mistake blitzing. But yeah, I'm going to try and move Annie there. And he does. Oh yeah, let's get the dice rolls up. Need to roll a 4 plus to move, and he didn't go really stupid, so that's very good. Okay, now these guys are pretty screwed. Samuel L. Jackson, Sidonie Weaver, and Sean Bean. But I'm going to keep him there. I could try and dodge him away, but you see how it turns red? He's going to make a dodge roll to get out of the way, which is dependent on agility, and I'm not going to. I'm going to end my turn. Quite happy with that. My throw is covered by the Rat Ogre. Pogo run all the way down there. Okay, then. It's snowing. Oh, we already got an injury on Sigourney Weaver. The fanatic injured. I see, I told you. All right. Result badly hurt. So that just means they're out of the game. No long-term effect. I am not going to re-roll that. I think that's okay. We've lost a player. So yeah, brilliant. Great start. Goblins are very good at dodging. Going to try and blitz. Pushes Michelle Rodriguez. Michelle. Her. If you get... What? There you go. Oh, knocked a troll out. The troll is knocked out. Yeah, troll tried dodging and failed. Did have break tackle, but didn't do him much good. Now, if you get pushed out, you take an injury, but the player who pushes you out doesn't get any experience for it. Nevertheless, I get 3 dice on this guy because I am so strong, he is so weak. I get 3 dice. I am going to try and do this and push him out. And I do. Now, because I've got Frenzy, I have to follow up. He's got injured. I'd rather have not followed up there, to be honest with you, but it's got him out the way. And I can move up, but there's a dodge roll there, so I could try and take him out. It's just 1 dice because he's supporting, but if I move this gutter runner here, going Danny Trejo, Danny Trejo, then Liam Neeson can batter this goblin, but this goblin has bloody sidestep. That means that he can go where he wants. So if I don't knock him down, he can just move here and get in the thrower's way. Nevertheless, I think I'm going to try it. Maybe we should move this bloody... I want to get rid of these guys this turn. I want to get the ball to him. I could just try and... Hang on. Yeah, I can't throw it to him from here. I have to move. I could try and throw it to that Storm Vermin, but the Storm Vermin isn't that very high in agility. You can throw, okay, because you got pass. And he can catch, alright, because he's got an agility of 4. So this is probably my best bet. And I can always re-roll it. Both down is not good for me. If I had block, it would be alright. I'm going to re-roll it. a push. Well, alright, and then he gets to choose where he wants to go. Do I want to follow him? I would say yes. He's dodged away. He's actually helped me. Thank you. Now, I could choose to move here and then make a pass. It's quite a low risk pass, but if I moved here, it's just a handoff, and then it's not even a throw, it's just a catch. And I've already used my reroll, so you know what, I am going to hand off and not even bother throwing this time. I would get a 1 experience point for throwing for the thrower. We've caught it and we've scored, good. So, Lickless Cage, you score our first touchdown. I didn't want to take the risk. It was low risk, but it was still a risk. And in scoring that touchdown there, not only do I take the lead, but I remove his loony, who injured Sigourney Weaver. I remove his chainsawer guy and his bombardier. So now all he's left with is goblins. And his troll does not wake up, so he's got one less troll for me to worry about. And trolls are pretty strong, but unbelievably stupid. And there they go. There they go. So that was probably a good idea for me to get rid of those. Organize my players. You're going to have 3 players here. I only have 10 players now. So I'm down a player. Which means I am kicking off, so I can just put you there, really. And we don't need anyone at the back here. And that means the Rat Ogre, Arnie, will probably be... Yeah, he's going to kick. Doesn't matter, though. If you don't have kick, the skill, everyone's equally good at it. Boom! That wasn't even a kick, man! Bloody Arnie. Yep. Nothing really happens there. If it bounces off, that's a really good kick, actually. Well done. Oh, if it bounces off, then I get the ball. No, he gets the ball. He gets to give it to any player. But he tried dodging through here with the goblin because he's an idiot. And the goblin failed his dodge roll. Even though he can reroll it. Because he's got dodge. Now. So what I could do. Blitz this goblin. Doesn't add sidestep. He does though. That one doesn't. Blitz him. He can't reach. I should be blitzing with the Rat Ogre, really. But he's a bit too far back. If I blitz him, then you can go and get the ball and score again. However, I did mention during the prelude that the gutter runners can indeed just scoff all of the touchdowns. Get all of this. He's got 3-star player points now. If he gets 6, he levels up. But that means your team's really one-sided. It's lopsided. So what I am going to do is blitz with Arnie. Hopefully. Gosh, if I do roll a 1 here because of his wild animal thing. Where is it? There. Then he doesn't get to move and I've wasted my blitz. But we'll see how we go. It wouldn't be a loss of a turn. A turnover. Alright, it's only a push. But it's alright. That's okay. Because I get frenzy, so I get another go. And we knock him down. Nice. But yeah, it wouldn't be a turnover because it's not that big a deal. Storm Vermin can move here. I should start calling them names. Kurt Russell can move there. Michelle Rodriguez can move up here. I'm just making them dodge, basically. The more times they roll dice, the more times they can fail. And, and then I'm going to get more chance to get a turnover. So I'm not going to take that much chances with my gutter runners just yet. There's no real need to. This troll's on his own, so he'll probably go stupid. If he's not next to another member of his team on a 4+, he'll just go stupid no matter what you ask him to do. So Nicolas Cage, what are we going to do with you then? What are we going to do? Because we can't really cover you, and that's 1, 2, 3 dodge rolls. Which you could do, I suppose. You could get there on 2 dodge rolls. Or what I could do is move Sean Bean up here. Maybe not there. That was a stupid place to put him. And have Mickey Rourke batter this pogoer. He's got dodge, so that didn't work. Alright, just push him there. And if you put no, He's on his own against three of them. I could actually get quite a good block on this troll, you know. Because every player who's next to you, who isn't next to another player of the opposing team, if you're paying attention, can add one to your strengths. So this guy's strength is three. This guy's strength is five. But because he's got two players supporting him, his strength is also five. That means it's one dice, because it's equal. If I put this gutter runner here, or this gutter runner here, which I think he'll do, that means his strength is six, so he actually gets two dice on him. All makes sense. And I push him over! Nice! Don't follow up. And that is actually a stun, so he takes two turns to wake up. And Danny Trujillo, that poor girl is going to run right down here. I know he is, so I'm going to put... Oh, I can go and get the bar, I suppose. But yeah, there we go. Now, we're actually really fortunate to be playing against goblins, because goblins are not a brilliant team. They rely a lot on dodging. Dodging is quite risky. Can't even reach the ball. That was a really good kick by Arnie. By kick, I mean boot with his... Well, swipe with his claw. Yeah, there's a pogoer. Don't know why he's doing that, but he fell over. This tail that the rot ogre's got is a minus one roll to their dodge rolls. Oh look, an opening. I can push him off the here now. But again, the Storm Vermin, Kurt Russell, will not get experience for that. Let's just move some players up, shall we? This rot ogre can... Arnie can completely just, like, hold those two, so we don't have to worry about that too much. That troll is down. Storm Vermin's got that going. Let's move this gutter runner up here. Let's move Danny Trejo up here. Like that, say. Michelle Rodriguez can batter that goblin. Let's move this, let's move Sean Bean. Sean Bean! No, let's not go that way, Sean Bean. I know you've got a death wish, but come on, dude. Be sensible. Let's pressure them. Pressure them. Cost, this has got me down there. And if he makes, like, a long bomb throw down there, I'll cover him with Mickey Rourke. Now, let's see. I do want to blitz that goblin. So, because he will not be there when I do that, Samuel Jackson can cover him. And then we can get Liam Neeson to maybe do some other stuff. I don't know! We've suddenly, like... I don't want to go near the troll. We have an abundance of players, and this is unexpected. But then again, I'm playing against goblins, and very fortunate. Should really try and farm them for injuries. And I probably will. So let's get them... Yeah, thinking about it. Let's get you near the goblins, basically. And Nicolas Cage, what are we going to do with you, Nick? What are we going to do with you? You're kind of like just on a limb there. I don't want to make that roll. Tell you what, we'll blitz with this... with Kurt Russell going for that goblin. Now he has block, which means that if I get both down, it doesn't count for me. But it counts for him. So nice. Well done, Kurt. No. That's better. So he's under a little bit of pressure here. I have given him a really nice run down here though, because tackle zones stretch adjacent to your guys, pretty much. So that's a tackle zone. You see it around this guy. But I've left him this strip in the middle. So what I wouldn't mind doing is moving you at least there, Nicolas Cage. I'm going to do it! Okay, 2 plus, roll the 6, that's fine. So now he doesn't have a straight run down there, I think. It'll be fine! End turn. Oh god, oh god. So that goblin's run away from him. I think I forgot to do a lot of blocks there, because I'm an idiot. I should have blocked, because... Okay, he's got the ball. He's got the ball. And now he's like, holy crap, I've got the ball. Yeah, he hasn't moved with the ball. And now he's failed the dodge. Well. So... This is quite nice. He does have sidestep, so he can dodge where he wants to, so I wouldn't be able to push him off. Except I would, because he would have to go there, there, or there. Oh no, he could go here or here. Yeah, because that's how sidestep works. You can sidestep, basically. So I'm probably just better off going for a regular blitz. But maybe I should try some other stuff first. I don't know. See, this is a nice block. But if I screw up with one of these blocks and roll red skulls, double red skulls, which I could do, that's my turnover, and I missed out scoring another touchdown. So I'm just going to go for this and see what happens. Okay, so that did not work, because even though defender has stumbled, if he's got dodge, he can ignore that. I could re-roll it. What turn are we on? Turn 5. I have 3 left. I'm going to re-roll it. I am going to re-roll it. That time we... defender down, which is bad. Sorry, attacker down, which is bad. And a push. So we'll push him. Do I want to follow him? I think I do. Yes. Alright, so that's the blitz wasted. Danny Trejo can sort of go here and, you know, go, hello. How you doing? And, yes, we'll move... Let's cut Nicolas Cage there. And we'll move Samuel L. Jackson around here. And this time I will not forget to block with people once I have positioned all my players. Where are you going, Michelle Rodriguez? I suppose we need you up there to pick up the ball, just in case. So yeah, we'll sort of have you there. Now then. Sean Bean! Batter the goblin! Batter him! That's basically a push, because he's got dodge. Let's push you there, and yes, I do want to follow up. Arnie, do you want to block him? You do, and that is a defender down, which is the best result. There's no skill that can avoid that. You know, I have Liam Neeson going, oh, well, what am I going to do? I don't know. Mickey Rourke can batter that goblin. We got, again, defender down, best one. My strength is higher than those than theirs, so I get 2 dice. He knocked him out. Which is nice, but you don't get any star player points for that. You get 2 star player points if you cause an injury. Right. This is looking pretty good. Turn 5. Turn 6 next. It's kind of hard to see. Alright, so you're just dodging over here. That's fine. You just dodge over there, matey. Now what are you doing? What's this guy? Oh, I stood him up. He's dodged him. Away from the side, for obvious reasons. And now... nothing. The AI does not like dodging or attacking. Sorry. No, thank you. I do not want another bloody window cleaner. Let us resume the match. Yeah, so the AI is just thinking about it. He doesn't like moving, like dodging, or blitzing with the ball carrier. AI will never do that, so therefore the AI will sit and think forever. Yep, forever. He's left us a message. Rats! My mouse got stuck, but yeah, rats. That was when we scored a touchdown. Rats is what we are. So this is looking pretty good for us. Let's not try and screw it up. Storm Vermin, probably the best, Kurt Russell, probably the best bet to go and batter him. I still feel the need to cover these guys, though. Pogo is in trouble, unless we decide to score a touchdown, which is likely. Oh, that's just a push. Now, I do have 2 rolls left, sorry, 2 rerolls left. We're on turn 6 of 8. We're doing okay. Do I want to push him? He does have sidestep, doesn't he? So we could just go up there and then I'd have to blitz him. Or I could go down here. I'm going to reroll it. Damn, that was wasted. Do I want to follow him? I'll say no. I should have, damn it. Okay, well now I can't move because I've blocked. Well, I do have a blitz with Michelle Rodriguez. So let's go ahead and do that. And again, didn't work because defender stumbles, but if he's got dodge, doesn't count. But if we get a skill to call tackle, that negates dodge when we attack. I do want to follow up. Oh, he's escaping! Get him! That's only one dice. I don't like one dice blocks. We do have Sean Bean to come to the rescue, though. Now, I can't blitz, but what I can do is put him there. And that will give a strength bonus to Danny Trejo. Oh! Who will push. And I will follow up. We're letting him just get away here, guys. But Samuel L. Jackson, with his two dice block, because he's stronger. There we go. Defender down. Thank you. Don't follow up. The ball has gone there. Well, I could have Nicolas Cage come and pick it up and then go for it. I mean, that could be a touchdown. If I dodge there, pick it up and go for that, that's a touchdown. But there's no need to rush things. And I have Tommy Lee Jones in the wings. I also have Liam Neeson just there. If I can batter that pogoer with Arnie, and I'll be able to push him out of the way at the very least, then Liam Neeson can come over and pick that up. Currently, it's a dodge away from the pogo. But if I knock the pogo down, and it's a shame not to use Annie. So, very good. That is a casualty. He was badly hurt. Two-star player points for Annie. He now has two-star player points. So now Liam Neeson go pick up the ball. This is where things go wrong. 3+. Hang on, before we do that. This guy has not got up at all. He's too stupid to get up off his ass. Should have put Christopher Walken in the list. Well, this still might not have been picked. I'm sure I'll get many comments saying about who should have been in the list of people who could possibly be in the team. Yeah, the crowd's getting for it. Crowd's revving up. Go, Liam! Go over there! Liam Neeson may well score a touchdown. This guy may well stand up and try and stop him, though. But we'll see what we can do about that next turn. So, what do we got? That goblin stood up. That goblin's dodged over there. And that goblin's going to blitz. And because that goblin's there, he'll get a one dice block, which is only a push. And now that guy's dodging over there. Really stupid. And that goblin dodged away. So, Mickey Rourke. Sorry, I'm wasting you by covering that goblin, but it's got to be done. So, yeah. I mean, what I could do here is dodge. There's no reason to think that Liam Neeson could dodge out of that, but I can't get rid of these two. I could wait another turn and get these guys back here. I'm going to move them anyway, because it's wise to do so. And I think I'm going to try the dodge. Surround these guys with Samuel Jackson and Sean Bean and get Kurt Russell into the fray here as well. But I'm going to try and dodge away here. And I'll re-roll it, obviously, if it doesn't work. Let's see if we can just get you into a better position. No, try and dodge you. Agility of 2 is not good for dodging. Alright, just get up. There's no way they can score anyway, really. Alright, there. And he's moving. He's been very reliable, is Arnie. Good old Arnie. I could try and dodge a gutter runaway. Not really getting anything for that, though. So what I'm going to try to do is basically just dodge there. I got a 3 and I require a 4. Reroll. No, Liam! Liam! You failed me, Liam! Bloody Liam. Right, he's obviously going to try and get a long throw there, but it's not going to work. Can he pick up the ball? He can. No, he can't! No, he can't! Right, so I've got one turn to score here. I did get lots of players around here, my 8th turn. Okay. Bloody Liam! How very dare you. Now, I don't want to risk blitzing with the rat ogre, even though it's a more substantial blitz. I think I will blitz with you, because I can't take both of them out anyway. So I'll blitz with Kurt Russell, and then have either Samuel L. Jackson or Sean Bean try and pick it up, or something. We'll do this anyway first. Both down, I have block. That is a knockout, which is not an injury, so it doesn't count. Now I can move up because it was a blitz. So what I'm kind of thinking here is throw is too far away. I should have got her over, really. I mean, I can go for it. I can dodge and go for it. Well, I can try and block him, get him out of the way, and then just run over here and maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's still a go for it, isn't it? Yeah, you can only move 7. And then you got to pick it up. And then I was thinking about throwing there, but she will suffer on her roll to pass because that goblin's there. Or I could just try and run in, pick it up, and score. I don't have any rerolls left, so it's the least... risky thing. So it's like I can jump in that and then run up there, but it's a dodge. It's a pickup and a dodge. It could actually be two. No, it's only one dodge. Oh, I don't know. Oh, let's try and get a pass out of it. All right, we'll move Sean Bean over here. He can try and receive the touchdown, and actually we'll move Samuel Jackson there just in case it like bounces off him. And then it'll still count, I think. Okay, and then we'll block here, which is where it goes horribly wrong. Oh no, there we go. There we go, diff down. Right. And then we'll move you. You have sure hands, you see. She has sure hands. So if she makes this go for it, gets a sure hand, she can re-roll picking it up. And re-roll passing it. If she doesn't fall over. It's a 5+, so it's not very likely, but give it a go. Oh! Yes! Sean Bean catches! Michelle Rodriguez throws! Very nice, guys. Very nice. Well done. Very impressed. We are owning this game. Does the troll wake up? That's our side. The troll has woken up. There he is. Well, we were gifted there for a while, but and the pogo is back in. So we are kicking off. Again, we only have 10 players because we only bought 11 at the start. So we'll just go with that. And if we look now, Sean Bean has 3-star player points. And Michelle Rodriguez has 1 for that throw. So well done. All right, Annie, you can kick off again by whacking it with your hand. It does scatter quite a way when you do this. Quick snap. The offense starts their drive a fraction before the defense is ready. Catching the kicking team flat-footed. All players in the receiving team are allowed to move 1 square. It's not that big a deal. I don't think he'll even bother. No, he hasn't. So he has 2 trolls back. If he gets blocking with them, then we're in trouble. That's why I tend to try and just leave them alone as much as possible. So I might try and dodge away because it'll probably hurt less. Do they have Mighty Blow? They have Mighty Blow, which has an increase in chances to hurt you, basically. So dodging away is probably going to be less painful even if you fail it. Oh god. Ow. Poor Sean Bean. He didn't get injured though. It's their last turn anyway, so yeah, okay, so they did try and form a cage up there, which is something the AI does quite a lot. Surround the ball with players and stops you getting at it and sort of edge up. Goblins are not so good at it because they're not very strong. But then they can just sort of like break out in a rash. Alright, so that goblin's still down. Just to explain this. These are all players that are out of the match. These guys have been expelled for being illegal. That guy has actually been injured. And then this goblin has been KO'd over here. Sigourney Weaver lies injured. This is the KO box. And this is the substitutes box, which we have none. And neither do they. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We both have 10 players. Alright, we'll keep that formation. Maybe should have moved Sean Bean back, actually, thinking about it, because he has got star player points now, so if he gets another gust of wind, scatters a little more than what it would. If he gets another touchdown, or, you know, he might level up, and then he might be some use. Goblin's dodging. Bloody loony's going, and he's got the ball. Oh, dear. But we're 2-0 up, and it's halfway through the game. We're 2-0 up, but you know, this is what you need. You need a nice, easy match first thing against goblins. Against Necromantic and against Nurgle, it's not going to be this way because they're a little more bashy than us, and you know, it's going to be difficult. Now again, he's making a cage. He's making a cage. I need to get Arnie in there pretty much to start throwing some bodies around. So that's going to be my priority next mission. Oh dear. Sean Bean got knocked out. He can wake up if we roll normally a 4+ because we have the Bloodwiser Babes. It's a 2+. So I'm not going to reroll that. We're going to see if we can go without him. And that was actually a both down result. So as you can see, the Troll has been knocked down as well. And that actually counts as a reroll. Now, as I said, my priority is to do this. Get in there, because he's supported by two players. I only get two dice rather than three, because I'm only a little bit stronger than him rather than a lot stronger. This troll is also really stupid, so I don't have to dodge away from him in order to move away from him, which is exactly what I'm going to do with Mickey Rourke. Mickey Rourke is going to go here. I need to get my two storm vermin in front of this as well, and watch him. Watch that bloody Stinag as well. Yeah, so let's move you, Kurt Russell, over here. We'll get Tommy Lee Jones in the mire. We'll also... I don't want to put anyone next to that troll, and I wouldn't mind getting rid of him, so that troll becomes really stupid. I actually want that goblin to move away from that troll. We can put Liam Neeson... it's a dodge roll because of that goblin. Nice to get players behind them. Michelle Rodriguez can cover this goblin. I think I'm just going to put her here. Gutter Runner can go around there. Nicolas Cage can run like the wind. He might try and block him, I'm not sure. And we got these two guys that I'm probably going to leave since they've covered that area. And see if Arnie wants to bother getting that gobbo. Doesn't get that strength bonus from these two anymore. Oh, well, I was aiming at him last time, but it worked anyway. And yes, we knock him down. Sweet. So move there. He'll follow up regardless of what anything I say. And yeah, now he's right next to the pogoer, which is where the pogoer does not want to be. And that's also, I should have done this before, silly me, move Liam Neeson away and just maybe here from the troll. So we got a nice line here. This is a little weak, actually, thinking about it. I might swap you guys. Put some, yeah, because the gutter runner's only got a strength of 2, you see. So I put you sort of like in there or something. Because there's nothing stopping them coming down here. Apart from Tommy Lee Jones and Arnie. And who the hell want to face up to those guys, huh? Nobody. Okay, the trolley. Oh my god! Oh wow! The trolley's dead. The trolley's dead. The troll is dead. Arnie earns 2-star player points, because that counts as an injury, by the way. Arnie killed the troll. I mean, it hurt. It hurt, obviously, because it's a bloody troll. But he'll be up and fighting again, because he's only knocked down. The troll is dead. That's quite rare, but obviously it happens. And obviously that counts as a turnover for him. That was actually a both down result, but you know. Troll is dead. Wow. So I can get right in this guy's face now. Storm Vermin running there, blitz him. Not a good idea. No, no, don't do that. Don't do that. No, Kurt Russell. I know you're all badass and stuff, but alright, what we can do is block that guy, get him out of the way, and then possibly force a block with you. Block, block, blitz. It's a stretch, but it's possible. And then maybe a block here. We'll try and get the ball. Now, against a stronger opponent, they'll just be bashing us out the way right now. So that's why... That's Skaven's fault. You know, they're very good at scoring touchdowns. Not that good at defending against them. But we're against the goblins. So let's have a go at this one. Nice. Good start. Move there. Don't move up, because I need to get in that space. That was just a stun. That's okay. Now, Mickey Rourke. The thing is... Oh, yeah, Mickey Rourke can push him there. If this works... Which it hasn't. I can re-roll it. I can re-roll it. Just to get in his face. I'm going to do that because I got 4 re-rolls and I never had that many in my Let's Play. So it was makes a change. Alright, so didn't work. No. Yeah, and he's gone right in the way. Because I was hoping to get Kurt Russell in there. I mean, I could still try it. In fact, I can do that without dodging now. That's really handy. And because there's going to be a gap there, we'll fill that with Liam Neeson. Let's not go next to the troll, Liam. Let's not go next to the troll. Give him free blocks on us. Right, Liam. Sorry, who's this? Kurt Russell. You have block. Both down. Oh, who's got it? Oh, and you've just picked it up, knacker. Bloody knacker. Well, we can have this thrower back to the goblin. This thrower being bloody Michelle Rodriguez. It's the only thrower we have. Dodge cancels out defender stumbles. So, it's just a push. And I think that will about do. I got this thing here. It's not really worth it. You've got a runner versus a goblin. It's a bit like a blancmange versus a puddle. So, except the puddle will win, you know. But you know what I mean. Blancmange versus a wet sponge. Oh, so there's another message. Come on, I was playing left-handed. So am I, by the way, because I am left-handed. Alright, so... Annie's on the floor. We can stand him up. Now, just a stand-up option would be a 4+, because if he's wild animal, it's not a block or a blitz. So I would need a 4+ for him to do that. And if he doesn't, he's on the floor. And also because he's a big guy, he's a loner, and so it's quite difficult to re-roll. You've got to test if you can re-roll, and if it doesn't work, then you can use your re-roll. So, as you can read here if you so wish. So what I'm just going to do is blitz, because you can blitz from a prone position. So I'm going to do that on that goblin that has the bloody ball, see if I can batter him. I'm quite happy with the way my guys are spread out here. Let's see if we can do this. Right. It says you rolled a 3 and you need a 4, but actually we rolled a 2. Well, no, we rolled a 1, sorry, which is plus 2 because we get the, you know, it's a block action, blitz. But that equals 3 and we need 4+. So I want to re-roll that. The thing is, with Loner, I would have to roll a dice, and on the roll of a 4+, then I could re-roll it. You know? And if I don't... So I need a 4+ and then a 2+. So it's a reroll I could use later. I'm not going to. As I said, we're okay. That was only basically to get him off his, you know, ass, basically. If I move this gutter runner up here, Danny Trejo, then Tommy Lee Jones gets 2 dice on him anyway. And we get a defender down. I do want to follow up. Oh, right. So this guy could try and catch. He needs a 4+ to catch it. I'm going to say no. Because we've got it under control. And besides, Liam, you can just go and pick it up now, right? And everything will be dandy, right? Sure it will. Okay, so... See, I can have Liam go and pick up the ball and then run up here. And we've pretty much got this covered. To sort of like preempt that, this lineman, Mickey Rourke, can come over here. Samuel Jackson can come... No, I don't need to move over the ball, man. There. And yeah. Liam, can you pick up the ball this time? Thank you. And... Because they're pretty fast, he can create quite some distance. As you can see. There he goes. Actually preview their movement. And you'll have to go for it to reach him. Which is another dice roll. And dice rolls equals failure. You want to roll as few dice as possible unless you happen to be blocking goblins. Yay! That was a knockout. So yeah, that's got rid of the pogoer. He'll appear here. There he is. He's out the game. Until he wakes up again. And there's a chance he can wake up after every touchdown or halftime. So Liam Neeson's looking on for scoring now. He's looking pretty good. Oh, God. Right, he tried dodging away from... is that Danny Trejo? That's Nicolas Cage. But yeah, you can do this. I can try and go for it and score in this turn. But I'm not going to. Because there's no reason to. There's no reason to take the risk. It's a very small risk. You know, 2+. But even so, we're okay. You know, we got this. We got this. Let's move Nicolas Cage here for no real reason. Let's see if Arnie can batter this goblin. No! He likes being down there, apparently. It's quite comfortable. Unless I roll double red skulls on any of these, I'm going to be okay. Push you there, and then Kurt Russell can have a go. Not having a lot of luck with these. They're quite hard to push down with all their dodging. Samuel Jackson, move here, and then Danny Trejo can get two dice on him. That's a knockdown. Nope. Actually, yes, go on then. And Michelle. Knockdown. Nice. No injury, though. See down here? There are injuries. Needs to roll 8 plus. Oh, I have to roll over that armor. Yes, so... And I rolled under it. Yeah, if you get over their armor, you fail. Did I not explain that properly when I started this video? I don't think I did. If they get over the armor, you got to roll low. You got to roll low for the armor. Oh boy, let's just score. If you can score, then score, because you never know. We're going to roll those double red skulls, and then it's, you know, then suddenly you suffer a turnover. Then that goblin that's right there comes and blitzes you, and then knocks you down. Then you die, and then because this is Blood Bowl, and this sort of thing happens. He is not waking. That guy woke up, but these guys have not woken up. So how many players does he have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, we only have our player woke up. Sean Bean woke up because we uploaded Wiser Babes to revive him. So yeah, we outnumber them still, which is nice since we only have 10 players. Arnie, just kick it off. Aim it to the centre of the pitch because that scatter can kick it up. You can send it round here. And then they just get the ball instantly. If it's on the floor, they have to pick it up. And that's a dice roll they can fail. Same as that. Yeah. Yeah. Well. Alright. Maybe... Oh, okay, let's just... that's nice. Okay, Kurt Russell, you go and talk to him. Have a word. Talk about the weather or something. Miss Rodriguez. Or Mrs. I'm not even sure. I don't know. Go and talk to him. When I realised what the bloody hell was saying. Now... That's only one dodge. I don't get a lot for it, though. I just put a gutter run up there, you know? Now, okay, it's one dodge, and they have agility of 4, which means they basically dodge on a 3+. So that's two rolls of 3+. But, you know, it's bad. You know, it's like, I'm actually tempted to take up this troll, you know? I might go for it. If I put Samuel L. Jackson here, this is a stupid idea, by the way, because if I failed... Rolling this. All right, hang on. Wait a minute. Well, it's only two dice, but you know what? All right, I'm doing it. I am. He fancies the other one now. Go on, Arnie. Batter him. And by fancy, I mean like kill him. Wants to kill him. Ah, now. Well, it's a. I could get like that, and they're both down. That's kind of risky. Or I could get the defender pushed, which will push him in the direction that I want. But then I attack him again because I've got frenzy. But that's what I'm gonna do. I push him out of this guy's... it's only going to be one dice, though. No, actually, it's going to be two. We're going to be all right. If I push him there, then Samuel will help. And then we knock him down. Boom. Nice. Now, I would really like to get him out of the troll's way, but it's okay. We're all right. So that was nice. Let's see if we can battle this goblin. No. Yes. That's actually quite nice because now you can move up here without... With only one dodge. I don't know why I'm so averse to dodging and I'm playing Blue Skaven. It's kind of silly, I know. I really should just... I'm going to make that dodge roll. Here I go to appease you all because I know you're all shouting at me. I am going to make that dodge roll once I move Danny Trejo over here to cover this goblin. I am going to... Move him over here. This is a dodge roll. Here we go. Woot! He made it! I could go for it twice and try and pick up the ball in a 2+. High agility means that you can pick up the ball easy. But we got them covered. We are good. I'm going to see if I can get Nicolas Cage leveled, basically. Remain one level out of this. You know, we've got a bunch of experience from this. You know, we got a pass in there, a couple of injuries, 3 touchdowns, obviously. He's got the... No, he hasn't got the ball. He hasn't got the ball. Oh, this could be a touchdown. This could be a touchdown. So you do not have sidestep. So, Tommy Lee Jones, if I blitz you in this direction, you'll at the very least be pushed over here, which is not ideal because he's stood there. But then again, Mickey Rourke's there, and he can go and get it. Got anyone else we can move, really? I'm not going to bother with that goblin. I am not going to bother with him. Because all that's doing, basically, is taking one of my players out the bloody pitch, the fight. So, I mean, Dianetrizio can bloody reach that, you know, from all the way over there. I think I'm going to go with this and hope that we can batter him. Yeah, alright, we'll do it like this. We batter him! Push him there. Yeah, move up. Yeah, because we've got this guy. Dianetrizio! Dianetrizio can just... It's a go for it. Ugh. Mind you, I can always just score on my last turn if I just move you there. So we're not going to level up Nicolas Cage, we're going to get both of them a touchdown. And we're going to put Mickey Rourke just... No, I don't want you to go over the ball. I don't want you to get the ball then. Sorry. It's not your time yet. So just move there. Cover that ball. Make that touchdown happen. And then we're just going to go and block some people and hopefully... Well, it's alright. It's fine. Oh, I got Samuel L. Jackson down here. Of course, you are right next to him, aren't you? It's kind of a risk. I'm gonna get rid of that goblin. Let's get rid of that goblin. Oh, no! Arnie, I really should have re-rolled that. I got nothing to lose, really. Oh, we can just do this one. There's your double red skulls! Alright, we got rid of that goblin, which means that... Okay, if he was stunned, that guy would have probably gone stupid next time. As it is, he won't, and so he'll hit Arnie, and that might end up being quite bad. I'm not sure. Nice! Who did that? Who did that? Give that man a medal. That was Sean Bean! Oh, he got 2-star player points. Nice. He's one away from leveling up. If he can get a pass somehow, which he won't, then, yeah, it's all fine and dandy in Sean Beanland. Which is Yorkshire, by the way. It would be the Yorkshireman who does best, by the way. It would be. Okay, so hopefully, it's their last turn now. We can just get Dianetrizio to score a touchdown here. I could have potentially... He's making it as difficult as possible for me. Oh, that troll brought tackle, which means he can use his strength as his... agility once per turn, because that is a skill he got. He's also got guard as well. He's a level bloody 3 troll. This game's a level 3 troll. All right, Danny, go get that. Yes, pick it up. Score. Thank you very much, and that concludes this week's match. A crushing 4-0 victory for the Variants. What a way to announce ourselves to the world. However, and we didn't get any long-term injuries either. He always talks crap at you whenever you score. He being the AI. And we didn't get any long-term injuries, but I don't think we've been tested yet, you know? I mean, it was goblins. You know, I was very pleased to see we got goblins, because now we have a head start. We have a head start. We rolled a 6 for our winnings. Do we want to re-roll that? No, 70 grand is lovely. Thank you very much. Now, every week, there's also a star player, a most valuable player, which we will see shortly after we look at this. So we had the ball 32% of the time, which is nice, compared to 34, which means most, you know, another 30% of the time, no one had the ball. Occupation on half, 16%, 83 in their half. Nice. We also got two catches, one pass. Don't know. Oh yeah, that's because it scattered once, didn't it? Or, can't remember. Four touchdowns, no interceptions, one most valuable player. You always get one most valuable player. I don't know why it tells you that. Seven tackles, three knockouts, three casualties. Inflicted, that is, and one death inflicted. We ran a long way, 82 yards, and we passed 10. That's not bad. Yeah, and there's the sustained stuff. No deaths, no injuries, which is quite nice. Doesn't say injuries there, does it? But yeah. So, who won most valuable player? Mickey Rourke! Mickey Rourke, who I think was an unsung hero. He was like, you know, always, he was a team player. I think he deserves that. And with that, he gets an extra 5-star player points. So he's won from leveling up as well. For them, it was Snag Grab. Whoever the hell that is. Oh, we can look at a replay and see injuries and deaths and such. And play statistics. If we just look at us, the very rats. There you go. If you're interested, yards running is where it'll all be at. Michelle Rodriguez, the thrower, ran 26 yards. More than Nicolas Cage, the runner. That's only down to my odd tactics, though. But yeah, I think the star player points earned justify the way that I approached that. I didn't want Nicolas Cage and Dennis Rigo to get all the touchdowns. They could have scored more, I'm sure, you know, if I'd have let them. And it's always a nice backup to be able to do that. So, you know, we got touchdowns, we got passes, catches, interceptions. If someone killed anyone, and Arnie did, casualties inflicted, so yes. Well, Arnie does, basically. You know, kills people, hurts people. Knockouts inflicted, blocks. I don't know what blocks is. I think it's blocks sustained? No, it can't be. So it's just blocks done. But, you know, none. So I don't think blitz count. I don't know. I don't get the blots. Yards gained from passing, yards gained from running. In, you know, casualty sustained. Yeah, she's got any Weaver, sadly. But she'll be alright next time. KO sustained. Sean Bean had a very eventful match, didn't he? Interceptions. Yes, if we try to throw the ball. Block sustained. Yeah, Liam Neeson got blocked once, apparently, in star player points gained. Yeah, Sean Bean, look at that. With a touchdown, he caught the ball. He's got a touchdown. He inflicted a casualty. He got a block in there somewhere, and he got knocked out as well, so, you know, it was pretty eventful for him. So there we are. There we are. That was the first match, and team value is going up to 100. I am going to buy an apothecary. That is pretty goddamn important. And we've got 30 grand which to buy more players, and we will need more players. And look, we have one fan factor now. People are like, oh, look at those. Let's see what how the other guys did. Next time we'll be playing against Necromantic. Nurgle won 4-3-1. So maybe they'll have some players out injured next time. We'll see. I guess that's for next time. But yeah, that's for next time. We won't worry about next time. We shall revel in our victory. And I should say thank you very much for watching. It's been a pleasure to play Blood Bowl for you again. I hope you enjoyed it. And we look forward to more Trials and Tribulations playing as the Very Rats when they are tested by a more sterling opponent. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Appreciate your comments. And... cheers very much. Toodaloo.